Podcast. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Brick Feed. This time, episode 104. I'm LJ.
I'm Buffalo.
I'm Tenebrain Victus.
I'm BX6 Trooper.
We're going to talk about Lego Overwatch.
Wow, we just jump right into it, eh?
Listen,
Let's just watch. It's the main topic.
You can figure out what we're talking about.
Is that what the thumbnail said?
Yeah. The promised day is here. Hashtag Lego Overwatch
has risen.
Now,
wait, Overwatch epic is name of all. Lego now?
Yeah. In fact,
that's quite the balance change.
Lego has bought, they bought Blizzard, and so now they own Overwatch, and now we get to see
really?
How they're going to balance the game. I think they're going to make everything
Is
made out of
Is it Blizzard
bricks.
Bigger than Lego? Like the company?
Pshaw, no way. Lego is the biggest company of them all.
Is it?
I'm actually not sure.
Yeah, like, do we have any, like, people in Wall Street or something in the chat who can tell which one's worth the most?
I do not think that we have our Wall Street contacts on standby.
That is
yeah, they're offline right now.
I love those guys, you know? They're great. They got all the info about them.
So I won't deny, I've been on a bit of a rocky path with Overwatch in recent months.
Really?
The Summer Games event was boring as dirt. Brigitte launched super overpowered and annoying. And the Halloween event was pretty lazy, so my opinion of Overwatch has kind of like sunk, but it's being rejuvenated a lot.
No,
partly due to the Lego sets, partly because they buffed Roadhog like 3 times and then accidentally nerfed Reaper.
Wow.
So I'm very
Thankfully.
Happy on that.
Thankfully,
is,
Lego
is
has...
How did they buff Roadhog? Is he one-shot again?
Thankfully, no. I hope he never becomes that again. But they thankfully, in these sets, spoiler alert, they nerfed him out of existence. But before we actually get into the main topic, let's go ahead and do the usual segment. What did you buy and or build this week? So, have you guys got
thanks
any
for
Lego?
Redirecting it, man.
Gosh.
Before it got too out of hand. So, there was a Reddit post that LJ directed my attention to yesterday where there was sealed Bionicle 2001 sets and sealed Roboriders, sealed Throwbots at the store that's over 20 minutes away from me. I had just passed by it like the day before, so I was ticked because I really didn't want to drive out that way again. But X showed interest in the Throwbots, so I went over there. All the canister sets were gone. The Throwbots are the only thing left. So I bought one for myself and one for X to pick up at Brick Fair. So for X, he's going to get the Amazon Throwbot, completely wrapped, sealed, never been opened before. And I got the, the Turbo Throwbot. But I also have a friend that gave me a bunch of Matza sets and Throwbot pieces, like, years ago. And I never built the Throwbots because I thought it was, like, there weren't enough pieces. And turns out I actually have the majority of them for the Electro Throwbot. So I'll be piecing that together after the podcast.
That's
so
awesome.
That's a really, really, really good find, dude. Honestly.
By Reddit or Envy?
By both. Like, Reddit picking it up and then main snipping them real quick.
But I wasn't real quick because all the Matza sets were gone.
Yeah.
The Matza are the less desirable of the two options.
Really?
I don't think so. I think the packaging for the Matza is common. Now the mint and sealed canister nature, that of course is going
to
make them very valuable.
I mean,
but everyone knows what the Matza canisters look like. Everyone in the community knows what the Matza canisters look like, and they're fairly common to buy, even if they're not sealed. I have never even seen a Throwbots box, let alone seen one for sale. I didn't know they had boxes.
Yeah, hold on. I've never seen the boxes before.
Yeah, they...
You know when last time I saw them?
When?
1999, when I bought the green Amazon one. So that's why I really wanted the green one, because that was like my first ever construction set. But I lost it at some point throughout my childhood. So now Envy bought it for me, and basically if Envy has like a sniper laser sight on him, I just have to protect the president him and just jump and take a bullet for him. That's just how appreciative I am. Like, this is one of those dreams people have, and it's just true now. It's crazy, dude. That's so at some point I'm gonna get that green little fella, you know.
Yeah, you better find a brick there.
I have to now, you know.
That's awesome.
That's a great incentive. For anyone watching the video portion of this and not listening to this just audio, there on screen is the Amazon Throwbot. That's set number 8505. And in addition, here is Turbo 8502. So those are what those look like. I actually have Turbo. My younger brother got Turbo. And Sam, it's a neat little dude. I prefer Amazon, though, because obviously he's green, matte green.
I prefer Amazon because I can get free 2-day shipping.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That is not a paid advertisement. Sorry, guys.
Unfortunately, we do not
have struck up some contract. We don't know.
We have not continued our Audible sponsorship.
Nice.
I do see Meso's point, though, about them being more valuable. Because if you look on Bricklink and you search for unopened Bonkle sets, they're expensive, but there's a lot of them. If you go and look at the Amazon slicer / throwbot here, for example, there's none unopened. Not a single one in existence.
Dang. That is fair.
So these are incredibly rare. Like,
but you won't sell it, will you? You'll keep it forever.
I will. I am going to. That
dude,
thing's going to come with
so
me in the grave, dude. That thing's going to be with me in the grave. I'm going to be buried with that box. It is not leaving my possession once it is being delivered to me from Envy's hands to mine, dude. It's just...
I'm kind of torn if I want to open it or not, because I kind of want a set. But at the same time, it does have like a lot of value not being opened up.
I would not open it because you can buy the Throwbots fairly common. I was able to get like all of them for like, I think, $30 off eBay.
Yeah,
one time.
They are pretty cheap.
Yeah, whatever, like, whatever one you want, I'll be happy to sell it to you at Brick Fair. Don't
yeah,
open
like
your box. Keep that as a trophy.
Like the whole, yeah, that's the thing. Like the whole thing boxed. Like it had, there's like a paper on the box itself, and that's just a very rare sight. Like it's a relic, basically. Like if people see that, they have to do a double take. They're just like, is that Lego? When is that from? Because it's just so incredibly old.
It's
before 2000.
In like the box.
Yeah, and it's the first ever sign of construction from Lego whatsoever in any regard. These were the very first these are the very first sets ever with bowl joints, weren't they? I'm pretty sure.
I'm confident. I would say they are definitely the first classical construction sets, period. They're definitely the predecessor to what ended up being traditional construction. And that's why I make a distinction to call Bionicle the Lego Group's first successful construction story theme. Because it's not the first, but it's the first one that actually took off.
Bingo.
Huh.
Indeed.
Interesting.
Yeah. Either way, congratulations, Mench and X. That is it's a good acquisition.
Thanks, Enemy, you're the best.
I am the best. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, my goodness. I additionally got a few things. Not anywhere near as interesting as what these guys got, I would say. However, the first one would probably be the... I don't know if I want to say lamest. I don't think it's actually that lame. I made an order on Lego Shop at home because I had some points saved up, and I figured, you know what? I need to get something as a gift for someone, and now would be a really good time to spend those points. So, one of the things I ended up getting would be set number, air quotes... 853569 notebook with studs. And this was not something that I pined for, by no means, but it was something that I used to go over the price requirement, because they were doing a gift with purchase. that gift with purchase, as we actually talked about last week, I think, is the collectible minifigure frame. I'll go ahead and throw an image of that right up on screen. And I was actually recently on the Bricks and Bits podcast run by Just Too Good and M&R Productions. And I actually badmouthed this frame because it is not a $75 value. And to not sound like a hypocrite, I still stand by that. It's just that I was able to acquire it through the use of my points. So I have yet to open it, but I'm going to eventually, and then put all the TTB minifigures in there. Trying to get the set number, but I cannot find it. I give. So anyway, the final thing that I got ended up being something that I was actually pretty excited for when I first saw it. It is a city set. It is set number 60202, People Pack, Outdoor Adventures. And the reason I'm super stoked about this is because it has a ton of new minifigure prints on the torsos, new ones I had not gotten before. It's got new faces, new hair pieces, and most importantly, the most important aspect, it's got a bald eagle. So I've met my LEGO Freedom quota for the year. And yeah, that's
you weren't kidding. That's a bald eagle.
Yeah. No, it,
that's 100%. Crazy. That's worth the set. I had no idea that was even a thing within LEGO. That's crazy. Now, that makes the entire set worth it for that thing alone.
It's very new. Like, this set is incredibly new. It's of this year.
Yeah, I remember glossing over this, but I had no idea the eagle was there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I'm personally more excited for the hair pieces and the new prints, because I'd make a lot of people in minifigure form, so it's very useful to me.
Oh, come on, but the bald eagle.
But of course, I mean, listen, it's an obligation. I'm a LEGO fan, and I'm an American, so I have to have this.
Okay, but you just said you're more interested in hair than a bald eagle.
Okay. Well, I mean, I can't be interested in a bald eagle's hair. It's bald.
Oh my god!
Got him!
But your priorities.
But in this set, though, there's a lady with the "Can I talk to the manager?" hair. In the dead middle there, you get one of those.
And
but she's like a grandma, though.
That is actually the one I was gunning for, because Fweff for a time had her hair short, spiky, and silver. And so if she were to do that again, well, she can't get the jump on me this time, because I could swap it out for this.
Ah.
Yeah. The one downside to the set is that it is $40. Now,
it's a lot of minifigures, though.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I understand why it's $40, but that is definitely not one of its selling points. Now, the entire order, like, this is excluding another item that I purchased as a gift. The whole order cost me, like, $6 total, because I ended, you know, I used my points. But yeah, no, I'm super excited to pop that open and start messing around with the minifigures and the prints and all that cool stuff.
That's really awesome.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good.
I like it, dude.
Sort of.
Yeah.
Now here's my question that I always love to ask.
Here we go.
Have you built the Ninja Knight crawler?
Do you want me to just do that on this episode?
Yes.
I'll do it, actually. I'll do it.
Do it.
I'll build it right now.
You won't.
What did you just say?
You won't. You're a weak loser who ain't built no sets.
Oh, man.
What would brick feed be without the sound of bricks? Well, right. Feed.
Where's my knife?
Hey, I'm eating while LJ's building. Brick feed?
Only crud.
Heck yeah.
Dude, don't eat on the podcast. That's not professional.
Too late.
No eating on the podcast. No. Bad. Stop. This is not an ASMR channel, dude. No.
Alright, Meso. I'm opening the set.
I don't care if it's chips refrigerated or not. We're
you
not
hear that?
Eating on the podcast, man. No.
Do you hear that?
They are in fact refrigerated.
Of course they are.
I hope you're listening.
Anyway, while you guys are on about that, before we get into Overwatch, we should like get back on our promise in which the new tradition we started from last time?
Yes.
Go on.
And the set, what we're doing, right, is this new thing where you guys put in the comments on this YouTube video, people listening to YouTube right now, not people listening to it live, anything. You put down any set, doesn't matter which, it doesn't matter from what era, just any set ever. You put it in your comment, and then the one that has the most thumbs up, we talk about it, no questions asked. And the very first one that we're going to talk about is 3314 police unit, which is hilarious.
Oh, heck yeah.
314 police.
From the point on here, like just from first glimpse here, we have football logo guy on the cover for no particular reason. He has nothing to do with this. And there's also a shell logo. And then also one of the police officers are using like a round Viking shield. And this other police officer that is obstructed by the football guy is just charging the thief with a megaphone for no reason.
Yeah, I don't get why the football guy. I mean, like, it's on multiple sets, but I just don't get why, like,
why is it here?
Kept it on there, yeah.
any thoughts, guys? Any thoughts?
I think that whoever says old Lego sets are, like, way better than new Lego sets doesn't know what they're talking about.
I think there's an aesthetic to things, and I can understand that personally. But I do greatly enjoy a lot of the modernization.
Missile, stop eating chips, man!
I think that's the Lego.
Yeah, this is my chips.
Okay. Never mind then. ASMR Lego bricks is cool. Keep going.
But yeah, no, I think. This is interesting. It's interesting for a few reasons. Obviously, it's an older set, of course, but it's also interesting because it's still during a time Lego was partnered with Shell, and that to me is fascinating because I think they announced either last year or 2 years ago.
Yeah, recently.
Yeah, recently that they're no longer going to continue a partnership with Shell. So this is kind of an interesting time capsule in a sense.
I do like that the back of the police truck lifts up. That's a pretty sweet feature compared to something like Ninjago City Chase, where like the police has this like police cart that you get cuffed in the back of, but it like it's very hollow. Like there's not much cover on the back of the police cart compared to this. I do like that there's two of them too. That's
a pretty get the value bueno of
not just
feature.
One but two, man.
I like
creative police designs and weaponry in this universe.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, and I like that they're just bright blue and that there's just a random seat and just full windows on one of the cars. Like, you can just have a police officer just sit in there very monotonous and just huge windows on the sides. This says all over the place. It's crazy, but I'd like to point out, or one of our Patreon chatters, Boo Knight, pointed out that this was released in Europe in conjunction with the 1998 World Football Cup. So this set is probably incredibly rare. It's probably really rare. It's super rare, you know. So probably not a lot of people have it, and it's probably a huge reason not many have ever seen it. And
that, man, is actually just interesting.
Yeah.
Huh.
Not as interesting to hold a conversation for more like 10 minutes. Anyway, Overwatch.
But it's
going to
highlight it, you know?
Yeah.
Let's get into this.
Remember.
Yeah, let's get into what everyone is here for, you know?
All right. Sorry, I'm putting a piece on. I'm building Ultraviolet or Ultraviolent from Ninjago. Okay. So.
Ultraviolet.
I mean, it's, yeah. Okay, so.
Very accurate.
We're going to start small, go large. Obviously enough, Lego Overwatch was revealed, not necessarily intentionally, unfortunately. It was found on Target.com and later on Walmart.com. So we now have kind of official images. For full disclaimer, we did get permission to discuss these and show them by Lego. We contacted them, we reached out, they said yes, Right now, you're fine. If that changes, we'll let you know. So, that's a disclaimer. They're not considered a leak. There's nothing confidential about them. They're here. Let's start off with the smallest one, set number 75970, Tracer versus Widowmaker at a whopping 129 pieces. I'll let you guys start while I build.
It is a very straightforward set. It literally just has Tracer, Widowmaker, and the payload, which Tracer can drive like a vehicle, which is one of the controversial decisions. But I believe his name is Mark Stafford, the designer for this set. On Reddit, he mentioned that he did that completely optionally. You don't have to do it that way, obviously, but it is a way to transform the payload into a play feature for kids, which I get and I actually appreciate because it adds value. And he also made a funny comment about how, you know, this way now the Tracer and Widow mains can know what a payload looks like. This set.
Got him.
Which was very funny. And I mean, it is accurate to the Gibraltar payload. It looks very accurate.
Yeah. I love when there's like license sets are able to capture a very vital part of a property in a very small set and accurate. Because this is quite a big part of the game. This is something a lot of people recognize. And I think it's a perfect thing to have in just a little set. I can see a lot of people who are just a fan of Overwatch who could have this on their shelf.
Like,
yeah,
Fwef.
It's just like, oh, it's
the only thing Fwef wants from Overwatch is just the payload. So now you can
yeah,
get it.
It's just a little payload to have on your shelf, you know? It's cute. It's great. I love it.
Yeah, I see a lot of people who are not familiar with Overwatch. They don't know what this is. And it's like, oh, these are just generic, you know, vehicles, a ship, a truck. But these are the core of the game, or at least of one game mode. You have to move this payload to a certain point in the map and clear various checkpoints as you go. That's how one whole game mode functions. So this is big. Now, minifigure wise, I think both are good. Both are very good.
Yeah, very all accurate. These sets just have amazing minifigures.
Well, we'll cross that bridge.
Okay.
I agree, but they're
we'll get into it. Don't worry.
Now, the two main criticisms I've seen are that Tracer's guns aren't that accurate, and there's another piece that's apparently more accurate. I don't know what it is specifically. I only saw the comments in passing, but there's a piece that supposedly they could have and should have used. And I've seen some people say that Widowmaker's skin is too, like, the colors are a bit too bright.
Yeah, it does kind of seem a bit more bright than it is in game.
But that might just be, you know, a side effect of translating into plastic versus the shadows that
and it just depends on like what colors they have.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's more so that they also even they want to have the colors be accurate, of course, but they also are limited to the color palette of the different plastics, all the different Lego colors they have available to them. Like they don't have a shiny, bright kind of purple pink exact color that Widowmaker has, but she should have those colors on her arms.
Yeah, that's
accurate. Yeah, like why are they not why do they not have the t-shirt double mold that we've seen all over the place?
I figure because those are a little more I assume. This is obviously a consumer assumption, but I assume it's because they're more expensive to produce, and this is a relatively cheap set. But again, that's just
an assumption. Of course, that's always the deal. It's just like the big selling point of all these sets are like the minifigures, as they're like in this sense of and this license, like. Basically, all these characters are like the poster characters for the property, so it would make sense to all of them to have a lot of effort put into them, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, no, I get
you. I don't know.
Also,
yeah,
Andrew McCulling, I don't know if I got that right, in the YouTube live chat said Star-Lord's guns, his blasters. Those are what a lot of people wish Tracer used instead. I apologize if I got your name wrong.
That's what everyone's saying they should have used instead.
Star-Lord's blasters.
They're just smaller. They're not more accurate, though. Because the whole thing about those is that, like, the main characteristic about those guns is like, the big, I don't know what you call them, like blue engines on the sides.
Yeah.
Which is, like, a characteristic which that they, like, they're, in LEGO minifigure form, they're trying to capture the most outstanding characteristics of them and just in like a very tiny shape, you know, and I don't really see, like it'd probably be a lot more aesthetically pleasing for her to not have those huge guns, but from a standpoint of whether or not they're an accurate depiction of the source material, what they have now is the best that they've got, basically, without just making it all new mold altogether.
Yeah, and initially, upon seeing them, I wasn't too big on them because, you know, they're these large, kind of bulky weapons, and I still don't like Widowmakers. I think that, obviously, the set designers did what they could, and that's perfectly understandable. And we did hear from Mark Stafford also on Reddit that the reason they do not have individual gun molds and instead have these brick-built ones is because they had to choose. For every new mold, they lose a figure. So it was a balancing act. And for that, I completely understand and appreciate the effort going more into the minifigures than their weapons. I don't like Widowmakers. Tracers is certainly passable, and some of the others going forward would be as well.
I think Widowmakers is one of the more passable of the bunch. We'll get there.
In terms of her weapon?
At least hers actually looks like a sniper rifle.
Like a sniper rifle. I just don't think it's an accurate depiction of hers.
Let me rephrase. It might not be an accurate depiction. It looks like a gun.
Well, yeah, so do tracers.
Tracers, yes, I have no complaints about tracers.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't look like a gun. I'm just saying it doesn't look accurately like Widowmakers.
Touche.
That's all.
Well, I'm preempting, like, I don't think she is in the same category as Reaper and Soldier.
Mm-hmm.
So to lump them together, I think it merits certain discussion brackets. There's Tracer and Widows, whose are good. They might not look like the characters. They're still good. And then there are Soldiers and Reapers who, well... Yeah, anyway,
at least Widow's gun looks like a sniper. It doesn't look like the sniper rifle that she has, but it...
Thank you for rephrasing my exact sentence.
If you're going to LEGO to get accurate small representations of modern weaponry, you're essentially going to McDonald's for a salad. Like, that's not the place. You don't buy LEGO sets to get accurate depictions of modern weaponry in a very tiny form. That's just not LEGO's target audience, and it never will be.
That's why it was so stunning to see them pick up this license.
Yeah, like, it's already a stretch that they are even making these Overwatch sets to begin with. Like, what you're getting these for the minifigures and the characters and the set pieces. You're not buying these to get a miniature that is accurate to a video game. That is a first-person shooter in a LEGO set.
I agree. And you certainly won't catch me complaining about it ad nauseum.
But
it does merit mention.
Yeah.
It does merit mention. This is more just, like, for us discussing as to, like, that's just not something you should ever expect from LEGO. But of course, you can criticize them till... You're red in the face.
But you've got to check your expectations.
Yeah.
Sure. But I wonder how, like, bulky that these are on the minifigures, like, if it, like, tips them over or not, because if they're too big. Because I do know there's some, like, oversized...
Widowmaker probably can't stand with that sniper rifle.
Yeah. Tracer will probably be fine. Widowmaker, probably is going to cant like a boat that has a hole in it.
Let's go ahead and move on to the next one.
Okay. Fair enough. All right, so the next one, let me see which one I have queued up. There it is. It's set number 75971, Hanzo versus Genji at 197 pieces.
Alright. So I actually like this set a good deal. Dragons is my favorite Overwatch short, bar none. And I feel like this captures that vibe very nicely. Complete with one of those random criminal schmucks who Hanzo beats up. Who has an actual proper like, gun mold, which is funny. And a health pack, which I really enjoy.
Where's the look?
I do apologize. I knew there was something I was forgetting. It's like, I look up, I switch the image, I read off the information, and nope, sorry, Meso, wrong one.
I also just posted the gallery for all of you to be able to peruse at your leisure.
How dare you?
That's a reuse of an old mold, though.
Yeah, I know.
But still.
This set's really, really cool, and I think that for $20, the shrine is good enough as a little structure to add some value to the set, especially since it's not just some random structure. It looks like the shrine from that video. The only problems with it are the minifigures.
Okay.
Once again, which is going to be a reoccurring trend. They're good. I like them a lot, but there are problems with each. Elge, you say your piece.
I'll be quick, since I'm building. Honestly, I find the Shimada brothers to be the weakest minifigure representations of this entire wave. Obviously enough, we've gotten some changes to the Hanzo, as many have pointed out. His left pec has been censored, so it's just a blank pec, which I find absolutely fascinating. In addition to that, he completely and utterly lacks his arm tattoos. His left arm is void of any tattoos. Now, I cannot substantiate this. I cannot verify this at the moment. However, I have heard rumor that one of the set designers, possibly Stafford, talked about why he doesn't have arm tattoos, and it's that they're a little bit too strained at the moment to be able to print on these minifigures, as they're working on something else that needs the arm printing more. So they weren't able to actually do it for a majority, if the entirety of these minifigures. However, they also recently got a new machine, so hopefully that'll help them actually work on that. But again, take that with a grain of salt. I have not actually seen anyone say that. That is, as far as you should be concerned, conjecture. But if that's the case, I understand. Personally, it doesn't bother me too much, because in the game, I don't like the Shimada brothers. They're annoying as all get out, and it's whatever to me. But for what they are, I think they're fine. It's just, I really don't like how much they look. I don't like Genji, even though his colors are accurate. It's just there's too much of that weird burnt orange, and it's not something I think of when I think of Genji. When I think of Genji, it's the silver, the gray, the green. It's not the burnt orange, even if that is the proper way to illustrate him. I don't like the green sword. Hanzo's bow is
generic. The torso is very distracting.
Yeah, it is. It sticks out.
At least Hanzo, like, the details might be missing, but he has a good appearance, he has a good aesthetic, it's Hanzo. Genji's very distracting. He has the Iron Man Marvel syndrome, where, like, he has the bobblehead, even though it's not as bad as it could be. It mostly works. But it's big enough to be worth pointing out, and like you mentioned, the sword and the torso. It makes him look far more bright than he should be, which might be a good thing for some people, because some people consider a lot of silver to be boring.
Correct.
So if it's, you know, that some splashes of color here and there, it's a personal preference thing. It's not like objectively bad.
Yeah. So, I mean, and again, I don't really like the Shimadas. They're obnoxious for me to play against in the game. So, and a lot of my opinions on these sets are based very heavily on game.
Yeah,
gameplay.
I was about to say, what's that? LJ's subjective anecdotal stories.
Yeah, of course. I mean, completely subjective and anecdotal. Also, except for my opinions on Junkrat and Roadhog, they're easily the worst characters in the entire game, because Junkrat has some balancing issues and Roadhog is just a flaming pile of garbage. Continue.
Hashtag three buffs. Anyway. It's a good set, mostly.
It's fine.
Do you have any thoughts on it, Yuta?
It did kind of remind me of a set that already exists for Ninjago, but I looked it up again, and it doesn't actually look that similar, so don't know, there's a mental comparison I keep making, but there isn't actually an issue here. That I think it looks good. I really like the the columns are obviously very simple, but I do like how bright red they are, and they stand out quite a bit in the set.
Your mic sounds different, almost like you're using an internal mic.
Give me a sec. Okay, it probably changed.
It's back.
So I think it looks fine. Just reminds me of a Ninjago set, but not really. When I looked at it, and I do like the red columns. I think they're very, the bright red makes it the set kind of pop out.
I agree.
I don't know why they have the random thug in there with the gun that actually makes sense compared to the other weapons in this whole thing, but
hey man, variety is the spice of life.
And a stretch,
yes.
Right?
At least need a real gun in there.
Yeah, man.
Waboo X, you have any other thoughts or no?
I think this set is incredibly great. I think this captures a very recognizable thing from Overwatch, just the very end of the Hanamura map, and it puts it in such a small package as well. And gets you both the Shimada brothers, because I feel like the same kind of people that are into Hanzo are probably into Genji as well, and I love that Genji is just holding a healing pack on the side of the box.
It's so funny!
It's so great. I honestly love the people behind these sets.
I need healing.
And I do agree on the whole Hanzo minifigure, is that just a big part of him is his visible also he doesn't have his tattoo. Like, these are all just very recognizable traits of Hanzo, so it's unfortunate that we don't have it. Genji, I'm not a big fan of Genji within the game, of course, for obvious reasons, but I do love this depiction in minifigure form. I think that the vest syndrome that is accurate to the source material. Like if you look at him as a character in like art in game and everything, he does have a different color on the side, so it does make sense for the printing to be on there, as well as it being a different color on his torso entirely. It's just that the color that they used, even though it does show him being that kind of color on him as a character within the game, it's that it does not translate well within the color that LEGO has used themselves, because the color that they have, which is the closest to the color of him in game, is very bright and sticks out a lot that you see here. So it would probably be better if that was like dark gray or something that just doesn't make it stick out as much, because right now like many have pointed out, it looks kind of weird. He doesn't look as streamlined as a cyber ninja as he looks in game, but his helmet is absolutely extraordinary in my opinion. It perfectly captures the look of Genji while it's still having that LEGO characteristic of it being like almost like a bubble head. So this is definitely one of the best set. Like, all these sets are really good, but this is an incredibly good set. I'm constantly surprised by the effort that they put into these sets. I think this is a very good set, and I recommend people buying it that are looking for these characters.
All right. That positivity, X. Balance us out. It's good.
I just objectively think this is an incredibly good set, but yeah.
You objectively think, boom.
Objectively opinionated think this is a good set. You get.
All right.
Yeah, it's good value. Good value.
It's very good value.
For all I criticize it, I'm definitely going to be getting it. My goal is to get all these because I like them, and Overwatch is actually something. Very rarely has LEGO ever released a licensed theme for something that I'm already into. It's usually like I find out about it through LEGO or all that. So this is a rare occurrence for me, and I'm going to try to get them since they're not that big. So this will be one of my first ones because it's cheap and good.
Wait, Master, are you saying that you were never interested in the Lone Ranger movie?
No.
That was a huge hit.
Lone Ranger,
good meme, X.
Jurassic
good meme.
World, Jurassic Park.
Didn't Jurassic World is our age Lone Ranger, I feel.
Oh my gosh.
It's so, except for it has dinosaurs instead of other stuff.
Pirates of the Caribbean and all that I wasn't into when they made the Lego sets. So.
You say I'm either sheltered, way, next... audience.
Can we talk about the Pirates of the Caribbean reboot? I know it's off topic.
No.
I know it's off topic.
No.
No one cares.
No.
We're talking about Overwatch.
I know it's off topic.
We'll talk about it some other episode.
We're moving on.
We're talking about Overwatch now.
We're moving on.
This is an Overwatch episode.
All right.
Pirate feed.
Next set is set number 75972, Dorado Showdown. And this comes in at a rough approximation of, this is a sad number, it's 419 pieces, so
it needed one more piece. What the heck, Lego
banned for drug conversation. Let's
oh my god, you're right,
come on, no.
What are you right about?
Quick,
what
let me see the buddy's rage to say Pirates of the Caribbean reboot. Okay,
okay,
no.
Shut up.
Oh my god.
Purple, are you gonna be here or not?
No, I just wanted to say that.
Go away!
Got him.
Good meme, Purple. Good meme.
What was it that you guys pointed out in this set? Because I completely missed it. What are you guys... What is it?
Don't worry
is
about
it.
We'll tell you, funny? We'll tell you when you're older.
I'm older than you, LJ.
The piece count,
that's
X.
What you think.
Oh! Yes, this is a cool set.
But yeah, no, go ahead and politely and calmly
go ahead
discuss
and discuss.
It.
Okay. So, this is a weird set. Because on the one hand, I love it. Dorado is one of my favorite maps. It's one of the better ones. And I'm surprised by like how what a recognizable piece of scenery they chose. Again, it's similar to the Genji and Hanzo set. Usually these random pieces of scenery in the set are just kind of there to inflate the piece count, but with here it's an actual recognizable landmark. Like, I know that archway, I know the fruit stand, and I love how you can actually walk in the upper part of it just like you can in the actual map. it's great. And then the fact that the payload is there and it looks awesome and you can actually use it as a vehicle, all that is fantastic. I think this is one of the better executed playsets. Because people who play Overwatch will actually want this, because I know what that is, and it's cool. It's
gosh,
just,
that truck
it's
is
just
so
the
good.
Minifigures. The truck is awesome. The truck is so fantastic. The problems come in with the minifigures, again. The figures themselves, I think, are excellent. I have very few complaints about their designs, except for McCree. McCree has been hit very similarly to Hanzo. He doesn't have his belt buckle printing, BAMF, which everyone kind of
at all?
No, his belt buckle is blank.
I have not seen a front view of that figure. What's
here? So I'm going to post a front view for you.
And Envy, you had a term for what is it was either you or X had a term for what the belt buckle stood for, right?
I think I was Meso saying bricks and minifigs.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. I think
it totally should have been bricks and minifigs.
That's what it stands for, everyone. Okay? So
yes.
Don't let anyone tell you differently. It stands for bricks and minifigs.
There was prime potential for like an Easter egg there. They could have even foregone writing and just put like a brick or something, and like a minifigure of hand, and people would have got it, you know. But they didn't. They just opted to leave it blank, which is kind of weird. But
that's
all right.
That's
minor. The real issue is he doesn't. Now I could be wrong because we haven't like seen high res HD pictures of these, but from what I can see, he doesn't have his robot arm. Only a gray hand meant to signify that, I guess. But I suppose for whatever reason they didn't want to give him two separate colored arms, even though that is McCree's... It's kind of his shtick. When I first saw the minifigures, something was off, and I couldn't put my finger on what it was. The way I described it to LJ was, he just looks like a regular cowboy. not really like McCree. And then I realized later on, oh yeah, it's because... He doesn't have his robot on.
Lone Ranger reboot confirmed.
Have we seen Soldier 76's hairpiece ever before? Is that
This is a new mold, but we haven't seen a full high-quality front-on image of it yet. Unless you count the outline.
Because I don't recognize it.
No, it's a new mold.
It is a new mold.
Yeah.
Yeah. Probably new for this thing, because considering it's a licensing. That headpiece for Soldier 76 is incredible. Like, so many purists that are military builders are just going to order, like, 500 of that exact headpiece for, like, their cyber army or something like that. That it's just, we've never had something so near future military-esque in LEGO ever. Like, it's just, like, LEGO's putting out so much variety of characters and pieces and prints at this point that so many, like, custom minifigure businesses that just thrive based on people having these interests are probably going broke because LEGO's providing that need themselves at this point. It's crazy.
Yeah. I hesitate to complain too much about McCree. I understand why they did what they did. I just think now that I say it, I understand why they did the belt buckle. I don't understand why they didn't give him his arm. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Also, a side effect.
Example with the silver arm they could have used?
I did not, actually. Oh, yep. Jay. Yeah, I mean, pretty much. That's the stuff already exists. There's a precedent for it. They just didn't for whatever reason. Now, another thing. Now, this one, it's not a solution. A solution does not exist. I just have to notate it. It's weird with him not having hair underneath the hat.
Elaborate.
It looks odd. I know they gave him printing, and I also know it's an impossible solution. But if you just compare that minifigure to McCree, it's very jarring because you can tell he's bald.
Well, okay. There is a solution. Yeah. We've seen it in several different LEGO sets, most notably construction helmets. They will put hair to the sides. They have done hat pieces with hair on the sides coming out of it. It just not this specific hat. And to its credit, the set does come with an accurate hair piece in addition. But you are right. When he has the hat on, it does look like he went for the buzz cut look instead of the luscious locks that we know him for.
Yeah. Like, I'm going to have my McCree with the hair on always just because it's more recognizable.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'd argue that he got the short end of the stick here. I feel like he warrants a just brand new mold that includes his hair as well as the cowboy hat, because with just a cowboy hat, like, no matter what you, it just doesn't look like his silhouette. It just
looks like it does come
cowboy.
With it.
No.
It's on the side of the back.
It doesn't come with the hat, the hair attached.
Oh,
to
okay,
the
okay,
hat
yeah,
itself.
I see what you mean. Yeah. Yeah, it does look really weird, though, because it's just how obvious it is.
No robot arm, plus no signature.
No hair.
No head,
no obvious hair.
Generic, uninteresting cowboy.
It seems very much that they just did not put a lot of effort into it. I don't know. It's probably because they probably could have, like, the few characters that, if they only had so many pieces, so many molds that they could have for this theme, I can see why they went the way they did with McCree. It's just unfortunate for people who are incredibly huge fans of McCree,
like me,
that they get this.
Yup, I'm bummed about it, but I understand. You know, I get some of it.
We understand why. It's just unfortunate.
Now the big ones. Let's talk about the big guns, and I mean that literally. Reaper and Soldier. Now, I own a custom Reaper minifigure, so I've perhaps been a little spoiled by his interpretation. I think this Reaper is very good, maybe a bit simplistic.
I feel like the face is still kind of smushed, though. I mean,
a little bit, but it's not like, I enjoy it. It's a good figure. I have very few complaints. The guns, people are criticizing. I think Fweff described it best off recording. It's like he took a broken pipe and, like, You're just holding like a big pipe instead of shotguns. But I actually don't mind the shotguns. Yes, they're a little big. They're brick built. They have those weird bits on the side that make them stick out. But they look like shotguns. He holds them like shotguns. I think that if that was their only solution, they did a pretty good job with it. I don't have any issues with him. Soldier, I do have issues with. Soldier is ridiculous. Soldier, it reminds me of Legends of Chima, where they would just have these ludicrously oversized weapons just to be cool, I guess. It's absurd. It's bigger than his arm. It's close to being as big as him. Like, if you put that gun down at his feet, I guarantee it goes up to his neck, if not higher. And there's no way he's going to be able to actually hold that in any kind of way without being on a plate. It's too much. Too much. And it looks very little like his actual weapon.
You know?
Well, they tried.
At first, I was awfully critical in my head toward the weapon. But over time, I have warmed up to it a lot. I actually really think they did a good job with this gun. I think it's one of the better brick-built guns that they've made. And, yeah, I mean, it gets the point across. It looks like the gun itself. And I'll be honest. Soldier has an oversized weapon. It's huge. It looks like somebody took a tennis racket and then put a bunch of PVC pipes on it and painted it a bunch of different colors.
Not to that degree. That's a rocket launcher. That's not a gun.
Listen, well, my point is, I think it looks pretty darn close. I think they actually did a really good job with it. And at the end of the day,
I mean, yes,
it's a Lego soldier gun. It's what they would take. Like, if I were a kid, comments withholding, I would definitely try and make it something like this. I actually really think they did a good job with it.
I don't know. It needed a new mold.
They need a bigger soldier figure to match it.
A soldier big fig win.
It looks like it. You're right in the sense that the colors line up in a way to actually make it so. But you know you have a problem when it transcends weapon type. Like, I'm not kidding when I say it looks like a rocket launcher or a cannon of some point.
It does shoot rockets.
Yeah. If I was a kid and, like, didn't know Overwatch, I would never guess what kind of gun that was.
Didn't know Overwatch?
You know, like, I know they'd probably portray it as a blaster anyway, so it wouldn't really matter. But it's just a cannon. And at that point, you defeat the purpose. It's like if you give Tracer brick-built weapons and, like, she had these two big, huge blocks on each hand, and you're like, well, that's not Tracer's gun. You know, you lose the character at that point. And I think they went overboard. But I understand why. If you can't make a new mold, you have to do something like this. And the only way you can get it to look like Soldier's guns is by layering the colors a certain way. And in order to layer the colors a certain way, they needed for it to be a certain number of plates long in order to do the white to the blue fade. I completely get it. I just don't think it worked out. As LJ would say, that's a con.
As I used to say. But I understand where you're coming from. Personally, I think I actually like it. Like, I'm critical of some of them. Like, I'm critical of Widows. I'm all right with Reapers. I think I said this in a video I made, that they're serviceable. But I've warmed up substantially Soldiers.
Fair enough.
Look, Soldier's from America, all right, and everybody around the world thinks that America's supersized in comparison to, like, everything they have. So it makes sense that he's got a supersized gun compared to everybody else.
Yeah. Okay. Soldier 19. Sorry, did I say 19? Fudge. Totally undercut my point. Soldier 1776 for a reason. I agree with Envy.
It's not a flaw. It's a feature.
Nice.
Oh my gosh. X, what do you think?
So, you know, absolutely every... I just want to... Like, you guys are all talking about Soldier 76's guns, but this is more towards Reaper's guns, and basically absolutely everything I said regarding Tracer's weapons, how I feel about the Reaper guns is the exact opposite. I think there's so many options that would have been better. And the first thing that came to my head, someone actually beat me to the chat, in the chat, that's the Mockingbird, and that is just these blasters right here that we've had in the past, used in lots of Marvel sets, used in...
Whoa, blast from the past.
Yeah, like these blasters right here, just in black with black binoculars attached to the end of them, would look a lot more like the actual shotguns of Reaper than anything else they used. And
that's what my custom figure has.
Yeah, like it's just it works so well, and it keeps the Lego aesthetic. It doesn't look too much like modern weaponry, but it still captures it really well. Now for Soldier's weapon, I agree with Meso that I see why they did all the things that they did. It just didn't work out that well. If I was within Lego, what I would have used would be this thing to the left here, but like black or white or some other color, and then you tried to balance the color by attaching something to those studs on the side there, and that just would come, like, it doesn't look incredibly accurate, but it does get the look across of him having like a big rifle.
Like, you maybe know? If the gun itself was blue and then they had white stuff on the sides.
Yeah,
the
you know, I don't know, something, you know. It I just would agree. It does feel incredibly Chima with that with that, like, Overwatch is not super realistic, but it's a bit whatchamacallit, like, it's a bit grounded in reality more so than Chima, so it does look a bit outlandish when you see McCree with that revolver next to Soldier with just a building of a weapon in his hand. That is just the size of him, basically. Like, I have to agree with Mess on this one, and I'm probably. And that's probably why he's in the payload to begin with, because he's just looking at the designers right in the eyes. They're just like, why did you do this to my gun? Why did you do
that
this?
That flat expression.
Yeah. But regardless, I do agree that this is an incredibly good set, because like the Hanamura set, it captures something incredibly recognizable.
Frame.
Yeah. For like, you can just picture Junkrat spamming launchers at your payload from the top there. But also, this is also an incredibly inaccurate depiction of the game being three DPS characters just on the payload. That is
Soldier driving it. What the heck, man?
No, it's like the
you
first
can't drive
one.
That in the game.
It's like Mark Stafford said, you know, it's an illustration of what it looks like, so those people know where to go.
Yes,
I hope. Real briefly. It is worth noting. I noticed this a few days ago, but somebody else in the YouTube live chat mentioned, if you look at the front of the box, or what we presume to be the front of the box, the brighter one, the set is based on Dorado, obviously, but the background is Castillo.
They're two parts of the same
map. I know that, but they're two different maps. At the end of the day, which... is fascinating, because on the back it's properly Dorado, but it's interesting. It's like if they made an Eichenwald set and then put the Black Forest in the background. It's just weird.
That's great. Next set.
I want to get this set. I'm probably gonna get this set just because that payload car is just so smooth. Like, if you look away from the exposed studs in the very back, it looks like something you'd see on Flickr, because the entire thing is just so smooth, almost no visible studs save from the back. It just looks great.
Yep.
I recommend.
Hmm.
Do you have anything else, or
yeah, it's the one that I'm most likely to buy out of the playsets, although I might get the cheaper ones as well, we'll see. But I do like that the truck isn't the I mean, okay, never mind. I was going to say it's a good thing. I realize it's a bad thing. The truck does not float. with RIP. They had to put real wheels under it.
Oh my gosh.
So never mind, not buying it now.
Oh my gosh.
Also, one thing, not to, were you done, Envy?
I'm good.
The one thing I want to point out as well, though, is that Reaper doesn't have leg printing. Well, I do think, I didn't understand why they didn't have him have leg printing, but you can get one of these guys' boots and just add that. And I feel like that would capture Reaper's lower half very well. And that's all I have to say.
Alright, and to illustrate that on screen, there you go. That's what that looks
like. I need my Mariachi Reaper minifigs.
Skin packs. Let's go.
Okay, you guys ready for the next one?
I'm ready for the next one.
Yes! Oh,
I was born ready for this next one. Set number 75973, D.Va and Reinhardt! Set has
Could
about...
we get a...
455 pieces of pure, unadulterated brilliance. Gosh darn, I love this set. I am emphatic about how great this set is. Gosh, it's so...
This one's probably gotten the most hype for sure.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's alright.
Get out of here.
It's alright.
A lowly roadhog man. But...
Dude, I don't understand this set, but it's great.
Dude, okay, yeah, I agree. I also don't really understand it, why they put D.Va and Reinhardt in the same package.
They put the best two selling points in one set without any stupid add-ons or anything. This is very unlike LEGO. They just put the two biggest things people want in just one set. It's crazy.
They probably ran out of set budget and couldn't figure out a way to work Mech D.Va into another thing in order to give anyone else a fighting chance.
Oh my gosh.
So they just made like a combo mech. I'm not even joking. Like, the sets are meant to be play sets, so like if you put Mech D.Va in a set with like Reaper,
yeah,
it's gonna be a little lopsided. There isn't any play value there. At least with here, they can have the two.
Yeah, there wouldn't be much of a play set to go along with it unless it was like really high priced.
Yeah, they probably ran out of a price budget, so they had to do it this way.
Okay, I'm gonna let you guys get all your thoughts out of the way first, because otherwise, I'm just gonna start gushing for the next.
I think that
5 minutes.
Reinhardt is excellent. We all had fears about how Reinhardt would be handled. I think they did it very well. The custom shoulder pieces are nice. The awesome build and complexity is really nice. The torso design is great. The helmet is awesome. The only problems to me are the hammer looks a little not right. A little very lackluster. And also the legs. It's common LEGO mech issues. The knees don't bend, that limits stuff. But more than that, they're very offset from the torso, which is not how Reinhardt actually looks. So the hips are very like wide and pronounced, but I understand that's an impossible thing to not have. So I'll give him a pass on that one. I think that D.Va is the better designed of the two because she's basically perfect. I can't think of any way they could have made D.Va any better than they did. Every aspect of it is great. The color scheme, the smooth aesthetic, the guns, the cockpit, the minifigure, the little details and stickers, and it's just great. The two together form easily the best set of the wave. And it will be day one for me as well, as I'm sure Elder.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would definitely find this to be like one of the more satisfying ones to build out of the whole series, probably because it is more like reminiscent of Constraction, although I'm inclined to say that like most of it would not be reminiscent of Constraction considering it's mostly bricks, but
yeah,
I think they did a really good job with adapting them. I'm wondering if Neek was on the team for Reinhardt. Nah, I'm just kidding. Because of the lack of knees. I don't think there's any feasible way to have put a knee in there with the way it's currently designed, but
nope, not with that budget.
At least you can T-pose with it. No. I think the torso, the upper chest part, like, sticks out quite a bit. If you look at the back box art picture, it looks kind of obnoxious, but I guess it makes sense. I'm I do find it cool that you can put the minifig Reinhardt in there, and that the head actually fits for the most part, like matches the scale of the suit. But I'm guessing once we actually buy this, it's actually going to be a lot smaller than the box art might make one assume.
Yeah.
The set is insane. I honestly, so many of these sets, I was incredibly skeptical to like Overwatch being a thing, but like so many of these sets capture everything you want from Overwatch, and this just, like, that D.Va is just by far, like, I rate LEGO sets based on how much you get per year. So if you buy like 5 sets a year, this should probably be this one of them. If you like Overwatch to any degree and you're buying one LEGO set this entire coming year, get this set. This set is honestly one in a dozen. It looks good. It's accurate to the source material. I would argue that Reinhardt is incredibly just out of oversized and everything, but I can see why they did it him in this size, because from a play perspective, having Reinhardt, if you as a kid love playing Reinhardt and then you can buy him in LEGO as a mech and you can put any minifigure you want in it, that is insane. And I would argue that the knee joints, like, you could very easily mod in knee joints. Just wait like 1 week after they like start selling these sets and just look up that mech guy on YouTube. He probably has like 3 tutorials out by that time, and it just, I there's not much to say otherwise, other than like the few things that don't look good stick out completely, like Reinhardt's hammer, but they probably ran out of budget at that point. It's still crazy to me that you get both of these in one set, and on the back of the box you can see that D.Va even has an alternate where she is chewing her bubblegum, and her as a minifigure looks incredibly good as well, but we don't see any weapon with her whatsoever in anything, we so we don't really, can't we really. We do?
She has a blaster on the side of the box.
Where? Oh. Oh, it's one of those big, yeah, that's not good on there. Please, but yeah, please. They also have the, like, they had unique molds for the shoulders, and if you look from this from a developer perspective of things happening in the background, if we had to have a terrible McCree minifigure and we had to have miscolored anything, like all those minifigures going bad for just so that we could get these shoulders on Reinhardt, I would honestly say that is worth it, because any person that has ever seen Overwatch will instantly recognize this, and even like if you look from them afar and blur your vision, they're probably just like, oh, that's just a screenshot from Overwatch, right? And it's crazy.
The shoulder piece was very important to get right, because if they couldn't do a unique piece, he'd have to be bigger.
Because those shapes and angles are incredibly weird, and honestly, I don't think there's too much more I could say. So without further ado, LJ, you fanboy, take it away.
One side comment. I think I can understand why Genji is more of the burnt orange color, because everybody in this series has a very distinct different color from each other. And I think if you were to make Reinhardt and Genji both very silver, there wouldn't be a lot of, like, it wouldn't be as varied as it is at the moment. I think everybody like stands out a bit more distinctly from each other because Genji is not completely silver like Reinhardt. Or I guess he could have been green, but I think it makes sense to me that Genji is probably colored a bit more than he should be.
I have another comment as well. I can't criticize the D.Va mech for not having knees because of how the legs are built. The ankle joints kind of function as knees because the legs are hunched. You know what I mean? Like, she can actually do poses with them, unlike the ankle joints in those other figures, which are 9 times out of 10 mostly useless. Not always, but mostly for any kind of action pose at all. She could actually do some cool poses. So props be to you. Now, LJ, take it away.
So, I'm sure as everyone is well aware, I main Reinhardt. I made an early decision when we first started seeing the game, before the beta even came out, the public beta. I was going to take one character, and I was going to do so well with that character, I would overcome the issue of only playing one character.
And you chose Junkrat.
How's about your And everyone thought I'd go Soldier 76, because I have a history of playing Call of Duty. Nay. I decided I would don the large, bulky armor. I would crusade out into the battlefield. For justice! For honor! With a giant flaming hammer! And it would be excellent! And that is what this set is, in one pure, honest, condensed word. It is just simply excellent. Now, full disclosure, I think D.Va is a perfectly great adaption. But I'm not a fan of the color pink, so I don't really care for D.Va, generally. Even if the adaption is spot on. So I'm pretty much only going to be gushing about Reinhardt. And boy, is he fantastic! It's just so good. I love how they pulled it off. I'm a little split on the shoulder armor, even though I think that it looks perfect. I don't know what the other applications for that could be. But honestly, I couldn't be happier. I thought they were going to make him a tiny little Nexo-Knight mech. But no, they gave him this entire brick-built suit of armor, and it's just pure Reinhardt! The helmet looks great, the design of the torso looks fantastic, the arms look stellar, and certainly, no knee articulation is absolutely a detriment to it. Make no mistake, that's not a good thing. Obviously, we know through various public conversations why they do that. Totally understood. But gosh dang, I don't mind, because it looks like it's from the game. They even have it so those lower leg pieces, the bumps are on the knees, like Reinhardt's default skin. You have the bumps on the knees. It looks so accurate. And the stickers are fine, even though stickers are a sin against man. But I digress. They're perfect. Now, the hammer is a tad spindly on the handle. Don't get me wrong, because it's supposed to be this giant hammer, which you swing around indiscriminately. But I'll forgive it, because the hammer itself looks actually, it's pretty fine. It might be a little too small, but you know what? I'll forgive it. And in addition, it allows the minifigure to be thrown around by the hammer. So, fair enough. We do have a Reinhardt minifigure as well, and that's fine. That's good. I'm glad that we have that option. The torso print looks great. The face print looks fine. The hair, I'm not sold. I don't think it's all too accurate. I would have preferred they went for another hairpiece, but I digress. It's a minor thing. So I am super sold on this set, getting it day one. I'm going to build the heck out of Reinhardt. It's going to be fantastic. I am so excited. Ah, gosh, it's so good. I'm done now.
No shield piece, 0 out of 10.
Die!
Oh, wait. Cool hammer? 1 out of 10.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh.
Who made that joke before?
Wow. One final comment. There are a few people in the comments on YouTube inquiring as to whether or not this set is its size accurate and whether or not, it's properly in scale. And it's a little bit of a tricky situation. So Reinhardt's mech suit is in scale with D.Va's, at least for the most part. They are actually comparable in size. They're accurate to the game. However, the suit is much larger than most minifigures. It is a little out of scale to minifigures. So it is going to
a
be
little?
Larger. Okay, fair enough. It is much bigger than minifigures. So when it comes to the actual rest of the cast and crew, it's going to be vastly out of scale. But when it comes to the set itself, it's almost spot on.
So if you buy this set and only this set,
you're
going to
be sold.
From Lego Overwatch, it's gonna look gray on your shelf, man. But anything else, you're kind of,
Now I feel like traveling onto the battlefield and bringing justice for my team.
After I build the set and we finish this episode, that's all I really have to say. I'm super pumped. It's so good.
We have one more set. Oh, after this, my dude.
Two more shots.
Two, actually. There you
two.
Go. Yeah.
Oh, no, I have.
I can't end it on a high note, unfortunately.
I have quite a few sets I need to do, but some of them are going to be left for other videos. So.
Alright. So. Go ahead and move to the next one.
Okay, we are actually... We're skipping the set number and the price count because one of these I want to get to before the other. We are moving on to... Oh, whoops. There's the alternate box cover.
Are we skipping Overwatch sets?
No. I'll explain in a second. For anyone wondering, okay. That's the alternative box image for the Reinhardt set. And look at Reinhardt with that just heroic pose. It's so good. It's so Reinhardt. Okay.
Covering up the wide hips very nicely, though.
Listen, indeed. He can plant his hands on his hips, Meso. Okay? It's accurate to the game, and it's accurate to Reinhardt! Next
saying,
set.
Dual purpose posing. It's like
I don't see Junkrat. I mean, friggin' Roadhog being here, being obnoxious and disgusting.
Oh, they'll get their revenge in wave.
Oh yeah, they're gonna be. You know, I hope they nerf them so bad that the set doesn't even resemble. Okay. Next set. Set number 75975. Watch Point Gibraltar. This set comes in at approximately 730 pieces. It is the largest of this wave.
This set is very controversial.
Yeah, no, it really is.
And it was Pharah, so I don't care.
Oh my gosh! Be here or be gone!
Come on, Purple, join
Fine,
us.
I'll be here.
Thank Yay! You!
Yay! How's it like being here?
Okay.
So anyway.
Okay, great.
I'm going to echo Kini in the chat. He says, hey, look, guys, it's the ship I didn't even know existed until last
Neither
night.
Neither did Purple.
I didn't know it either.
Or Envy, I think.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, I didn't see it lift. I've never seen it lift off in the after a game's over.
That this is the biggest part of the set that is weird. Because it has a very elaborate, detailed, and admittedly pretty cool-looking shuttle build. But that's not something that apparently some people associate with Gibraltar, even if it is on that map and is the one of the core elements of the map. It's not.
Yeah.
It's not immediately in the purview. There were a million more iconic things they could have done for Gibraltar.
This is arguably the worst playset, and it's the most expensive one.
Yeah. Now, in theory, it's cool. If you take it away from accuracy to the game, and you move it onto like a playset, I really appreciate the verticality of it, having the cool shuttle build that can actually dock, lift off, and has the tower that like Reaper is scaling in his shadowy wraith form while shooting at Pharah flying vertically through the sky, and Mercy who can like trail behind her, and then Winston who can hop around vertically. It's like it's very character oriented if you actually want to play with it, like I'm sure kids will. Like you can do a bunch of cool scenarios, adding Pharah's ability to like fly the rocket for some reason. That's
why doesn't that the person
the only ever... character one of the few characters fly. That just have free flight, and she's just in a rocket
and she's the one piloting.
Yeah,
she's not even in like the box art. You know, if you look at the actual image and not the alternate one on the back, I wouldn't even know Pharah was in it.
Yeah, you can only see like a yellow on the cockpit, and that's it. And you just can't. This is so weird, honestly. Like, I see why they, because kids love, like in their internal focus groups, people probably love this just because it's a huge vehicle, it's a huge ship, you can swoosh it around and everything. But like, this is the most expensive set where they had the highest budget, all the piece count.
It's also,
you know,
one of the only ones that isn't like priced well. Like the rest of the sets are actually under the traditional price per part ratio. I think most all of them are under it. This one's over it by a lot. 730 pieces for $90.
Wait, what?
Go figure.
Hold on, $90?
Yeah. Why didn't we get like...
Yep, the Brickseek estimate is $90.
That's listed.
Why
on
didn't
Brick
we get too? Like?
Yep.
Why didn't we get, like, for example, a room on the Hollywood map, for example, as, like, a set piece? Like, there's so much other things that come to mind that they could have done with that piece count. And they had to just make a big vehicle.
Well, I mean, the challenge is they already made the Gibraltar payload as, like, another set. So they were probably like, well, what do we want to do here? My solution would have been make another map as the payload set, but I digress. They were probably like, we already have two payloads. We can't do a third payload as a big set. We have to do something unique, and the shuttle is definitely unique. I just don't think it works as well as it could.
Mm-hmm. Are there any, like, capture point maps or whatever? Or, like, the King of the Hill ones?
I mean, yeah, there's not in this way, but there was totally a potential to do that. They should have done that.
Yeah, they could have done Eichenwald Castle. That would look cool.
Ooh, I'm sure they will. So cool.
I'm sure they will.
Would it have done it justice, though, for the
not
same
even
film?
Close.
Yeah.
Not even close, but you can see what they've done with smaller piece counts with the other sets in terms of capturing Hanamura, in terms of capturing a Dorado. Like, just think what they could have done with 700 pieces. Like, they probably could have made like the bridge section of Eichenwald. Like, that's just me throwing out ideas. You know, they could make the little point that the house on one of the parts and the Ilios map. They could have done that. They could have done the big payload on the Junkertown map, for example, coming out, and then they just could have the spawn point room as like a set piece in there. I feel like there's so many more things that they could do, and that I'm definitely hoping, of course, that they keep. I mean, they're going to sell well, but I hope that they get to keep the license for years to come, and we get more sets because there's honestly so much they can do.
Yeah, I would be a lot less harsh on this one if we knew 100% sure there were more coming. As it stands, I kind of have to presume, like, okay, if they only are ever going to do these six sets, the fact that they chose this one is kind of disappointing. But, you know, that's all right. Let's talk about the figures, because they're also controversial. A lot of people are irritated that we're getting a second Reaper, which I understand, because again, if this is all we're ever going to get, don't reuse minifigures. But at the same time, I really appreciate they gave him his Wraith smoke tail form thing. That little attention to detail is very appreciated, and the fact that he can, like, scale that structure with it, that's neat. And Winston knocked it out of the park.
Yeah, Winston's great, dude.
Winston
looks like Winston.
Yep, everything's there, which I really, really appreciate.
He is a big fig, though, which is unfortunate. But as a big fig,
it had to be done.
He does what we need. He needs to do. Like, but are we only getting this wave of sets ever? Is that what you said?
No, we have to presume that, though. It hasn't been announced. Okay. We're getting more. But
I see.
I'm sure we will. I hope we will.
Yeah, these are going to fly off the shelves, so...
The real controversial ones are Farrah and Mercy, for a variety of reasons.
Get to it.
Okay. Farrah reuses Nexo Knight torso armor.
I don't know what's the big deal about that. Like, I think it looks fine. It gets the point across. Like,
but is it accurate?
I mean, no, but it's also a minifigure, so it's not going to be, like, perfect.
Well, could you be at all reasonable? Okay. I mean, for the record, I agree with you. I'm just listing out, like, the cons people have had. That's definitely one of them, but I agree. I think that if they didn't give McCree his robot arm and they didn't, like, give Reaper guns, I understand why they didn't give Farrah unique torso armor.
The wings are bad.
See, I don't mind the wings. I actually like how they look. I feel like they get the point across. It's just... she has two on each side in game, and she only has one on the minifigure. One on each side. That's the worst part. If they could have found a way to, like, branch it, or even, like, yes, a new piece to give the two branches, it would look better.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. Like, you're knocking them... like, you're okay with them not having a new mold, but not okay with them not having accurate wings.
Yeah, it's kind of
They
clash very strongly. If I had to choose one, I would have definitely, like, chosen wings and reused her plate. And getting neither is kind of eh. But the helmet's cool. The printing's cool. The gun, I don't know if it's accurate, but it looks like a gun. And for that, I respect.
Yeah, it looks accurate.
It's not a brick-built monstrosity cannon, so for that, I appreciate it. Mercy is also controversial because she uses reused Shima eagle wings instead of, you know, new wings.
Shima coming back to haunt us.
Yeah, overdone weapons and wings. And
Tommy Anderson armor. Was waiting in the wings. Not literally. He remembers the days of our Shima coverages. He's like, you know what? I'm going to get you, TGV. And then reintroduced him into one of our favorite franchises. Like, bam!
Yep. And now her staff. Her staff is another controversial element.
Yeah, her staff looks really basic.
Now,
so basic.
LJ explained it very well by, like, explain it how you did.
So, Mercy's staff has two modes. It has a kind of contained mode where the three prongs are down more into the staff. So it just kind of looks like she's got this really elongated beehive that's made out of white plastic on the end. And when she's using it, it stretches out fully. The three prongs stretch and they spin. This looks a little bit like instead of picking one or the other or attempting to do as accurately as they could, which I imagine would be potentially feasible if a bit oversized, in my head at least. They instead went for a more middle road option where it's kind of halfway out and it's silver instead of white.
Now,
why is it not white?
Here's, it's like they, what they did, I think, instead of in-game, they looked at a piece of concept art is what I think they did. Because if you look at this Mercy concept art,
oh, yeah.
I knew exactly which one you were going to pick.
Yeah, like, if you compare the two, it's outstretched. It looks silver in that concept art. It might be white still, but I mean, it looks silverish. I get it. The staff doesn't really bother me. It is definitely lazy. But I understand it. The wings are really the deal breaker. They look nothing like Mercy's wings. Not having that golden hue is a killer. That second layer of wings should have been recolored to be gold. Like, yeah. Can I add two layers to them? Yeah.
Yeah.
But all things considered, I'm not really bothered by the minifigures in this set. The other ones are worse to me, but they have some issues.
I don't have issues with the wings per se on Mercy because she, like, whenever she's in non-flight, they don't light up like that in gold, and I think asking for printing is a bit stretched on, like, the wings. I do feel like they get the point across, but I like, you could argue about whether or not this piece is this color and this piece is this color, but the thing is that when you're customizing a minifigure and you're trying to adapt something in a minifigure form, then you're doing anything you can to get across the most, like, just outlying characteristics or whatever. And if you look Mercy from afar, her arms look mostly white. When you just look at her, like, you could argue that most of her arms are probably not white, but when you look at her from just first eye glimpse, they look mostly white. So I do at the same thing about the staff itself. I think it's okay for them to use that piece. The fact that they're not using it in white makes it just stick out even more and makes it just look more like a hook than her actual staff. And also, one of the defining characteristics of Mercy on her is the whole, like, I guess you could say, like, the dress thing or whatever on her on her lower part of her body. And they could have easily done that with pieces of cloth, you know? I don't feel there's any excuse for them not having that. And it makes it, it's the same issue as, I don't know who Thevi is. I'm sorry. I don't know any reason why they didn't do that. And it just makes... It has the same thing as, like, McCree. She just looks really bare. It looks like something is missing. And Fowry is very, very self-explanatory. It's really weird. The biggest set with the most pieces has the most unrecognizable thing about with the most sought-after minifigures from a character standpoint, because, like, Mercy is an incredibly loved character. It's probably the most sought-after right behind Tracer from just a general consensus from the top of my mind. I could be completely wrong. I'm not super smart and know everything. And so it's just really weird that this big set just has so many minifigures that, like, save from Winston, it looks like these two figures got the short end of the stick and they put them in the most expensive set. And it's really puzzling. Yeah.
Yup.
Still better than Iron Man versus the Mandarin, I agree, Mr. Kevin.
never forget the flesh power buggy of doom.
Yeah.
All right. Let's go ahead and move on to the last one.
Well, Envy, did you guys have any thoughts?
I like the verticality of it. I'm personally not interested in a primarily spaceship set, though.
And yeah, honestly,
we've already pointed out the flaws in the minifigs.
Yeah, honestly, I'm not even going to get the set, even if it does have Pharah. I'm probably just going to get Pharah off of Bricklink.
But purple, completionism.
I am so not a completionist.
But purple, farmers.
Yeah, okay, so see, I think that's the most controversial aspect of this set. The fact that they're endorsing the pharmacy strategy.
Strategy.
Listen, I've played enough Overwatch with this group to know that our main weakness, and this is a bit of a hint for anybody that fights us in Overwatch, our greatest weakness is verticality. Please don't. Cannot handle Pharah or Mercy. We suck at it so bad.
It's true. It's very
Why
true.
Would you tell them that?
We can't
they beat
handle
us
it.
Multiple times the last game night.
We can't handle it. We're so bad. Even with a soldier, we're just too outclassed by that strategy. And so the fact they're endorsing it sickens me. Okay. I'm just screwing around, of course. Anyway.
Yes, if they didn't make a set with those two, the strategy would cease to exist.
Correct.
Meta would change.
That's 100% accurate. There's no line there.
Can I... Just before we move on to the next set, I just want to do something that I find cool. There is a set that is incredibly similar to this that is non-licensed that only has a 30-piece count difference. And I just think it's a better set in basically every single way, and it's for the exact same price. And I give you this set right here.
All right.
Oh, man.
But X, that one's out of date. Nobody cares about out of date stuff.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
oh,
but
this is
I
a blast
have that
from the past.
It's just the first thing that came to mind when I saw this.
That's so good.
This is set number 7690.
Lego, where did you go wrong?
7690 MB-01 Eagle Command Base from the Mars Mission Wave series.
Now, that's a playset.
That is a playset. Yeah. I remember seeing this when it came out. And it's like, wow, that is, oof, that's beefy.
Yeah. But yeah. Right.
You guys ready
for
the last?
That's it. I just wanted to show it for comparison. That's really it. We're here to talk about Overwatch. Let's do that.
All right.
I'm here for the last set. My personal favorite of the wave.
Last one. This is set number 75974, Bastion. It comes in at approximately 602 pieces.
Bastion.
The reason I skipped over this for the last... like playset with minifigures is because I felt like this is a nice end cap and it otherwise would have broken up the theme because it's a bit of an outlier.
It would.
Yeah, a big constructible Bastion set that can transform.
This thing is insane.
Is it as good of a value or is it as commendable as like the Reinhardt and D.Va combo pack? Not really. This one is more in line with what I would expect. But oh my god, is it well done. It is incredible in every single way.
It's accurate in terms of color and the fact that it transforms and still looks accurate. It's just insane.
I did not expect that the transformation was going to be a thing without rebuilding. I honestly did not. It's so cool. And yes, batteries included for some
reason. It lights up. It lights up.
Yeah, the eye. It's got a light brick.
And he actually has proper elbow joints, too. Like traditional ball and socket, not ratchet. Which is cool.
What?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's fairly straightforward. If you want to go on an analytical perspective, I'd imagine there's tons to say about it. But I just see this thing, and I'm like, yes, this is what I wanted from Illego Overwatch. This Bastion and D.Va, they are the highlights of the way. These big brick-built characters. I don't even care that it's not in scale. If you want one in scale, yeah. You have the Omnic Bastion.
Well, okay, the Omnic Bastion, is the verdict's still out on that.
It's more in scale.
Well, yeah, it's more
in
scale.
It is more
scale,
in scale. Yeah, I would argue that, yeah.
Don't know if it's going to be the exact representation. But yeah, no, this is actually... I mentioned this also... in a video of mine, that I think this is wonderfully built. It is the one I'm also the least interested in.
Bah!
I'm not saying it's bad. Like I said, it's amazing. It's so well built, well designed. I think the functionality is incredible. Obviously, it's got the light-up brick, and it can go into turret mode. That's great. It looks brilliant, super accurate. If we got a Reinhardt like this, I'd be all over that, like peanut butter on bread. But... I also don't play Bastion. I have no interest in Bastion. That's why this does not interest me. And that's simply all it is. It's an amazing set that I am not going to get. Yes.
I feel...
Bastion works.
I know Bastion works.
I feel this set is going to bring people who like Overwatch into LEGO. Because they're going to buy this one set. And they're going to tell themselves that they're just going to get this one LEGO set. And then they buy it, and then they just find out how incredible LEGO is, and then they just drop video game as a hobby and just become another LEGO guy, and then they go on Facebook and find Kevin Hinkle's comic, and then they're just a LEGO fan from that point on.
I don't know if I want that. Not the finding Kevin Hinkle's comic, of course. Like, it's a good comic. I don't know if I want all of the Overwatch YouTubers to then become LEGO YouTubers at that point. Think about it.
Could you imagine Unit Lost making news videos every time there's a new theme coming out? Man, that'd be something.
Oh, gosh. That's like, hey, everyone, this is Nickel O'Nickel. Today we're going to be talking about the latest theme. It is a new original IP that the LEGO group has created today. And we're going to talk about that for 10 minutes over the 10-minute mark, needlessly.
Yes.
I have nothing against O'Nickel, by the way. It's just an example.
By O'Nickel.
That's what I never said.
Thanks, Meso.
This, you know how we've been talking, or I've been talking, a lot about the colors that are within Genji? The Overwatch universe. Where it just does not translate well into LEGO's colors. This set has the colors of Bass translate into LEGO's colors perfectly.
Yup.
I mean,
incredibly commendable.
Yeah, the sand green, the bright orange, the beige tan, whatever you might call it. This is an incredibly high quality set. This is some ultimate collector's set degree.
Bastion, yeah.
And you know how much this costs, X? If it's to be believed? Only $50.
What?
I don't know if that translates
like skeptic.
To you.
It's like too good to be true.
AT and Mange are very skeptical of the prices. We're getting them from the
No, Dorado and this database. One are the only two I'm skeptical of. Everything else is believable.
Yeah.
I want to believe, but I'm going to be very skeptical about 600 pieces license set.
Batteries included, transformation.
Batteries? Oh, dude. This thing is honestly insane. It's completely out of scale, but as a standalone set, this just looks incredible. It's incredibly recognizable. I just can't believe how they got so much right with these Lego sets. I like it, but of course this is only something that I would get if I was rich, because it's out of scale, and I prefer everything in my Lego collection to be the scale of a minifigure, just because I just like consistency, man.
Touche.
Yeah.
All right.
Envy Purple.
Anybody else? Purple's gone.
Purple's gone.
We lost Purple. Of course she is. My goodness.
She was here, and then until she wasn't.
I didn't even
terrible
know
writing,
someone
but
named
she,
Purple could
terrible.
Leave until I, she did.
Oops, forgot to post that. I swear, it's like, to be here or be gone. Just tell me when.
To be or not to be.
She just wanted to share her thoughts on Farah from the John.
All right, well, this counts as a podcast appearance. I'm putting this on my Google document.
Did she not get to tell her thoughts, though?
No, she did.
Oh, okay, well, that's all right, then.
Ugh.
Quick, give your thoughts.
Me?
Anyone who still has them.
I have thoughts on the Overwatch, this line as a whole, and one other thing, if you want to hear that.
I find myself wanting to buy more sets than I realize I did. I'm definitely not getting the $90 one, though.
Touché.
Same.
I'm going to try to get it just because I want completionism, but yeah.
I've never completed any series, so I don't care.
So, what I do like about LEGO picking up this line is that this is a very rare license set, in that most license sets that LEGO pick up, or licenses in general, is just like most sets will become kind of samey. In that, like, old Jurassic World sets are like a bluish vehicle with dinosaurs in it, and the dinosaurs are kind of the main point. Lord of the Rings were mostly castles. But with Overwatch, they're so incredibly varied in characters and locations that I feel like they can put out a lot of different sets or lots of different waves, and it'll still feel fresh and bring something new to the table, considering all the character and set pieces they have. And also another, that's incredibly good news, but another incredibly worrying thing is that now that LEGO has opened up to making sets within a license such as Overwatch, I think it is inevitable that we will someday,
don't say it,
get Fortnite.
I knew it.
I'm so sorry. It's gonna happen. We're gonna have the dab minifigure.
Okay, I'm not saying that I would buy, like, I would never dab. Make no mistake.
All right, Fortnite bus set win.
But
has Fortnite become that thing by now? That it's has Fortnite finally become that thing that it's cool to hate? Is that have we finally?
I think Fortnite is the new Call of Duty in terms of hate. To be honest,
I'm happy if people have fun with it. I've played it and I can't stand it. But then again, that's me with like Battle Royale in general.
Obviously. Yeah.
It's not just PUBG I hate on, it's Fortnite as well.
Yeah.
Kazapar, why does this exist?
I do not like Battle Royale for the same reason as I don't like dice games.
Who said listen?
Which is the same reason that you don't like dice games, just you don't think it applies to Battle Royale for some reason. I don't like running around a big map, not doing anything for a long period of time, and then like and then randomly die.
Well,
guys,
no.
Did no one else hear that? Was that just the voice?
I said, listen.
Oh, was that you? Okay.
I'm not saying that those two things don't also apply, but there is another dynamic to Battle Royale, and that is the build-up. The goal is not simply to run around and
what's going on, my builders?
and either kill or die. It's to run around and survive. There's an end goal. And with dice games, it's run around and you just die over and over and over again. And sure, you can look at
that
in the same way as Battle
Royale. You can do that
in
Fortnite too, though.
Yeah, of course. You totally can.
And I do respect the build-up phase because I enjoy it in games like Age of Empires and stuff. It's a different kind of build-up, but the spirit is the same.
It's like there's a an atmosphere to them. There's a tenseness, and it's always different every game, unless you do die immediately. In that case, it's pretty samey. But you get in the game so quickly, it's fine. So I like that aspect. That's what keeps it interesting to me. There are fewer redeeming qualities.
It's okay to have opinions.
And that everyone, is how you derail a podcast from Lego in 3 easy steps. Buy my book.
Buy his book, guys.
Is Fortnite
Audible Trials?
Is Fortnite real play?
Meso, I think I would actively quit if you made it the title. I swear.
I might do that.
No, you won't.
But it'd be so funny.
No, it wouldn't.
Think about it. It's not clickbait. It's a funny quote. Said in the episode, like our old titles.
Meso, I will go to war. I will go to war. Don't you dare.
It's Fortnite real.
Wait, who said that?
A Lego Battle Bus set would sound like wildfire.
Yeah, I know. You said something, and then I heard part of it and said, is Fortnite real? Like,
oh my gosh. It's... Fortnite on a corner.
Come on, X, back me up here. Back me up. Didn't
don't do
funny?
It.
About what? What's your point?
Making
that the title of the podcast.
Don't do it.
Fortnite real Lego.
The title of the podcast is going to be Lego Overwatch something. That's what
that's
we've
boring.
Been talking
no,
about.
No, that's accurate. That's what you're going to make it.
I don't care
Hero
about...
Hero is the one sandwich that funny titles.
That's not
Before
funny.
Before I forget, by the way... Everyone remember to put in the comments a random set that we can talk about. The more obscure, the better.
Is Lego Overwatch uninspired set design?
Oh my gosh. Get this tripe out of here.
People were criticizing
Lego Overwatch's
it. Lego
budget gone to Fortnite instead.
Oh my goodness.
All right, let's go ahead and wrap this up.
Okay, in that case, go ahead and wait. Wait, do we have any other thoughts?
Not really. Overall, I think I guess we can do closing thoughts.
Yeah, let's do closing thoughts, man.
Overall, I think the wave is mostly a hit. There are, twists and turns along the way. Some things do not necessarily live up to expectations. Some things are adapted poorly, and some things are just downright questionable. So I understand why some people, both fans of LEGO sets and of Overwatch, might not be over the moon excited. But for me, most of my boxes were checked, and I think there's enough variety there in terms of construction. We have small vehicle-oriented sets for kids. We have sets with some structures to them that aren't just random structures but to inflate piece count. There's actually thought put into them. And then we have 3 fantastically done mechs that I think really make this a well-rounded theme. There's something here to love for everyone, whether you're a fan of Overwatch or not. And I am very pleased. I will be attempting to get every set.
Okay. Envy?
I think LEGO's played it fairly safe with some of the designs that they've made on this, more so like the piece usage. But I hope that it takes off successfully so that they can be a bit more adventurous with what they want to create, like pieces they want to create for a potential second wave of LEGO Overwatch.
Okay.
Overall, it's good, though.
Excellent.
I think all the sets, most of the sets, are really good and bring a lot to the table, and it's a lot better than I thought it would. And I am definitely getting some of these sets and actually having them together because they make great set pieces. There's only the very lingering thought at the back of my mind that anytime I would pick up any of these sets at the store, I'm giving LEGO a higher chance of someday making Fortnite sets, but otherwise I think this is a great addition to LEGO comparatively to other licenses they've been doing. This is a lot better than Lone Ranger in my opinion, and I very much want this line to be alive until we get an Orisa figure.
Oh,
yes.
Orisa figure, huh?
Like Orisa. Orisa, the comments.
Yeah.
Meso.
I didn't say it.
No,
took
yeah.
Took it from
no, okay.
Chat. Keeney. Kini gets Kreditze.
Fair enough. Oh, come on. Come on now. Still building. I'm almost done.
Congrats. Builders. I wish I could build my set, but you guys said keep it sealed.
Builders, sit down.
Okay. What? But no, I honestly do think that this is a really solid wave. I think LEGO did an excellent job adapting Overwatch into a LEGO wave, and I'm personally quite excited for the future pertaining to this series. I'm obviously immensely pleased with the Reinhardt figure. I think that despite its flaws, really? I can't think of ways they could have done it better. I know of fixes, obviously, but given that I'm sure they have constraints, I am super satisfied. And that's the one I was worried most about. I think that, for the most part, the smaller sets end up being kind of fun treasures. You know, neat little surprises that kind of really take you off guard and make you go, huh, okay, I didn't think I was going to like that. But I'm excited. I think that this is going to be a good one. I hope for more. And, I mean, listen, 2 out of 2 as far as, I'm 2 out of maybe 3 or 4 licensed themes that I've really enjoyed. The other being, of course, LEGO Minecraft, which I think is some of the best LEGO sets that they've ever made. So, in my opinion, of course.
Haley in the chat, until they make LEGO Fortnite and LEGO Overwatch is canceled. Imagine that. We get invested in LEGO Overwatch and it gets canceled like Bionicle.
That's very interesting, Haley. By the way, did you get that letter I sent in the mail about you never being allowed to be on another Ninjago cast ever again? Whoops. Did I say that out loud?
Okay. Nice. Like, Overwatch sold well. In the end, sales were fine.
Oh my god.
It doesn't even matter.
I don't think that scientists could engineer a lemon to be more sour than you are, Mesa, about Bionicle ending again.
I've transcended sourness.
Could I get a Gaudium in the chat, please?
I have transcended lemons. My lemons are gonna burn your house down.
Yeah, bring it. Who here has the last name of Johnson? Didn't think it was you. Goodness gracious. Nice. But yeah, overall, I'm super pleased. I'm looking forward to picking up Reinhardt and D.Va day one. As soon as I can get a hold of it. Do it. I will. Okay, well, in that case, I think we're pretty much done. I've been trying to speed build as much as I can to get the set done before the episode ends, but that is not realistically going to happen, and I'm not going to artificially inflate the length of an episode just to accomplish that.
Props for doing it. You proved me wrong.
Correct.
After almost a year.
Okay.
I'm kidding. Not a full year.
I don't badger you about things you haven't done. Thank you.
It's because I do them mostly.
Notice how he has to say mostly.
Well, then really? I build all the sets I buy. So, there are things that I have done that I don't do, like the iTunes feed.
Yeah, like the iTunes feed or that one viewing sync.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, or our Bonk Let's Play.
Or the Bonk Let's Play that you said you'd get out before I did something or other.
Yeah, dude. Where's that video at?
I haven't cut it together.
Yeah, that's what I
When's
thought.
Viewing sync coming back? Talk to Var. We have like 3 recorded.
Talk to Var. He says, having admitted GT4. That he hasn't edited one that he was going to.
Well, but for me, it was the full version. Any in general, that ain't my jurisdiction.
All right, fair enough. But either way, my point stands.
LJ, where can I find the latest game night?
Oh my goodness. Wait, the latest game night?
I'm reading Kaspar.
He doesn't sound anything like that. But no, yeah, no.
Go ahead and end the episode.
Okay, fair enough.
Are we still in the episode? I almost fell asleep.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, we need to end this quickly so X can sleep.
Yeah.
All right.
We need to end this quickly so I can go
watch Bevan Binkle asks, where's the 4th or 5th Brick Fair ending video? Well.
Are we getting roasted by Kevin?
No, it's because I made 2 endings to the series.
So. It's a very meta theme that the fun at Brick Fair never ends.
The real Brick fun. At the
real
fun
Brick
Fair
endings are in your hearts.
Oh
except
my gosh.
If you don't want it to end, then don't. It's all up to you whether it's over.
That's such a telltale ending. I don't know if that's actually like a telltale ending. I've never played one of their
games.
The
only telltale ending is bankruptcy.
Yeah.
Thank you all very much for listening to the Brick Fiend podcast.
Hey! Don't you dare.
You're not doing it.
Yeah, listen, because we're having a conversation. It's natural. My goodness. You're fake, Meso.
We naturally end this?
All right. Thank you all so very much for listening to another episode of the Brick Fiend podcast. If you have any thoughts or suggestions or some unique and obscure Lego sets that you want us to talk about next time, feel free to head on down to the comments below and leave your thoughts, critiques, and anything that you want to say, whether it be insert an example here. Make sure to head on over to Patreon, patreon.com/theTTB channel, where we just finally confirmed shirts are coming back. So those are going to be coming soon, hopefully. Additionally, we also have a contest over on the TTB message boards. It is an official TTB contest called Master of Dragons. There are some prizes kindly provided to us by the LEGO group that are going to be offered up for all of you to enjoy, provided you win in three different
hashtag
categories.
Sponsored, hashtag be ninja, hashtag.
Gosh, I can't wait for you to go, I don't know, do whatever you're going to do. So thank you all so very much.
You know you like my comedy.
Meso, he's the worst. He's the worst character. Why is that always so loud? Okay, groove music sucks. Thank you all so very much for listening once again to the Brick Fiend podcast. I am LJ.
It threw off your groove. I'm Meso.
I'm Envy.
I'm dead on the inside.
I'm sorry this one ran so long, guys. But
it's okay, man. It was worth it.
Yeah. It's about the sets we talked about along the way.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. You got this, man.
Thank you so much. We'll see you all again next week. Or next 2 weeks.
See
whenever.
You. Bye.